Hello, gorgeous. Bienvenidos or welcome back to my channel. It's your girl Liz, and today I'm here with a new video. In today's video, I'm putting to the test a few items I picked up at Sephora, which is the new LYS Skin Loyalty Setting Spray, the new Makeup Forever HD Skin Concealer. This is not new, but it's new to me, which is the Triclone Skin Tech Foundation by House Labs, and the Huda Beauty One Quote Wow Mascara. So if you're interested, then go ahead and keep on watching. But before we get started, don't forget to subscribe to my channel, give this video a big thumbs up, drop a comment down below after you're done watching this video. So let's do some makeup. I'm going to zoom you guys in so we can see a little better. I already went ahead and I did my eyebrows, I did my eyelids. The skin is already prepped and ready to go. So let's get started. So I want to do half of my face with primer and the other half without primer. Also, I'm going to be checking in a couple hours to see how the foundation, the concealer is wearing. I'm gonna use the Sephora Blur and Smooth Primer, or Smooth and Blur Primer on half of my face, like I said. A little bit, because a little bit goes a long way. So my right side, which is this one, I'm going to use the primer. I'm going to let that primer sit on my skin for a little bit, and then we're gonna move on. Oh, my skin is itchy. All right, so I think it's been a minute already. I got my foundation in the shade 330 medium cool. I have no idea if this is my shade, but we're going to find out. Ooh, she's fancy. She is fancy. Wow. And heavy too. Let me read a little bit about this foundation, because since it's my first time using it, I have no idea what to expect. So it says it's a clean, cutting edge, long wear foundation that delivers superior makeup performance without compromising your skin. Infused with 20 plus skincare ingredients, buildable medium coverage, luminous second skin finish, ultra fluid, weightless formula. Alrighty. She has a pump right here. Damn, I like this packaging. I forgot to tell you guys what I used on the eyes. I used the Forever Floral by ColourPop. So remember, this side I have primer, this one I don't. Oh, I forgot to tell you guys, I'm also using for the first time the Sephora Micro Smooth powder. All right, let's go in. Oh God, I think that's dark. It's okay. So I'm going to use a sponge. I'm going to use a brush to blend that. Right away, I see that's very luminous. Is this my shade? Let me see. Actually, I think it doesn't look bad. It's a little bit dark, but since we are in summertime, I think it could work. What do you guys think? I see that luminosity peeking through, and I like that. Definitely, you can still see my birthmark that I have right here. So I'm going like, ooh, ooh, ooh. There we go. Remember, this side doesn't have any primer. It feels lightweight, like a skin tint type of feeling, you know? Which I really love, because I hate when I feel like I have makeup on my skin. I think this foundation has a big variety of shades, which is awesome. Also, I forgot to tell you guys what moisturizer I used. Maybe that's why it's a little bit extra glowy. Let me show you guys right now. So I used the Dose of Colors Energizing Serum brightens complexion and reawakens tired skin. So I used this one first, and then I used the moisturizer because that's like the way they say back here to use it. And this one is the Hydra Dose Daily Facial Moisturizer. This is what they look like. Well, I'm going to let the foundation sit a little bit to see if it creases or whatever. And I'm going to move on to the mascara. So I believe they only have one color. It's called Very Vanta, one brush, two sides. What? Ooh, she's pink. She's cute. She's Barbie. This is what she looks like. And I'm gonna open it right away to see the wand. Okay. I love the packaging. Like pink, I love pink. Alrighty, so I'm going to zoom you guys even more in so we can see this dramatic. I'm gonna have my mirror right here. I am seeing length. I have very little and light lashes. Okay. My lashes go all over the place. Like one is straight, the other one is curly, the other one is this way, like a hot mess. This is what they're looking like. I feel like they're a little clumpy, just a little bit, but I think it's because of the way that my lashes grow. I don't know. So I'm pretty impressed with the mascara, especially because it's one dip and you get this much results. So I think it's pretty good, honestly. I hope she doesn't flake or she doesn't transfer down. Let's cross our fingers. Moving on, let's do the baby right here. So this is the Makeup Forever HD Skin. I got mine in the shade 2.5N. Let's see if I got a good color. Ooh, she's looking light as heck. All right, but that's okay. Since this foundation is a little bit dark, I think we can make it work. Let me show you guys. Looks like this. Oh, she's looking light. I don't like my concealers to be so light, but it's okay. If anything, I can exchange it. If I like it a lot, I will exchange it. If I end up not liking it, it's going back. Period. I'm not gonna have something in my drawer just to have it, you know? As complexion experts, we created a formula that blurs it all. No more fine lines, no more imperfections, just a natural looking skin. HD Skin Concealer has a feather light gel cream texture with seamless buildable coverage that you can build and blend as you wish. It's ideal for all skin types, and it's available in 26 inclusive shades. Color correcting, hydrating. Okay, so let's put it to the test. I'm scared with this color, but it's okay. I'm a little congested right now, but I still can smell a little bit of that like makeup-y fragrance. So since this is hydrating according to Makeup Forever, I'm going to apply it and let it sit on my skin for a few seconds to see if it dries out or if it blends good or whatever the case may be. So let's get in.
Oh, she light. She definitely light. Oh my god.
It comes with 0.15 fluid ounces. And this is what the wand looks like. It's like a little bit flat sideways and then just like that. And it's a little bit like flexible, like very flexible. I'm going to use the LYS bronzer stick just a little bit. Guys, I always like to make this clear. I am not a makeup artist. I just enjoy playing with makeup. and like sitting here recording. I don't know, it gives me joy. Like, I feel so happy every time I'm like getting ready, setting everything up to sit down here and record. I don't know, it's just like, I don't know. It feels great. You gotta get that double chin out of here, girl. Goodbye. To blend this side, I'm going to use the Rare Beauty concealer brush. Okay, so it's definitely very blendable. Like, that literally melted into my skin. I feel like I can still see a little bit of darkness that I have here, right here. So I'm going to go back and add a little bit more. It's very lightweight and hydrating, which I like, but the shade is not right. And then I feel like it could be, let's see if it's buildable, because honestly, I think for the price, it could do a little bit more. So I applied again more, and I'm going to blend it. All right, so let me give you guys a close-up so we can see. I feel like after that second application, it has more coverage. I have to blend it a little bit more. I'm going to use the sponge right here. I think this is the Sonia Kasha. I have very, very creasy under eyes. So as much as you want to say that it's creaseless, not on me. It's already creasing a little bit, but it's fine. I really don't mind it. I'm going to move on setting with the Sephora Micro Smooth. Let me zoom you guys out. Oh. To set everything in place, I'm going to use the Sephora Micro Smooth. Yes, Multitasking Baked Face Powder. I have mine in the color 35 Bronze. Number 35 Bronze. This is my first time using it. Okay. Oh, thank God. I thought it was going to be too light, but it's actually perfect. I gotta set this nose because this nose is oily. Wow, I like this powder. I'm going to set my bronzer with the Black Radiance Pressed Powder. I got the shade Bronze Glow. This is not my first time trying it. I've used it before. So now for blush. I got this blush from the Sailor Moon by ColourPop. And I freaking love the packaging. I'm obsessed with cats, so this totally grabbed my attention. I got the shade From the Moon. And it's this gorgeous pink. I don't even want to mess up the... It's so cute. I don't even want to mess it up. Look at that. Grabbing my brush, I'm going right in. Okay, we got pigment. Oh, she's cute. I love it. Okay, put too much. Always do this. Look how cute. I know the camera's not picking it up, but when I do the checking, You guys are gonna see how gorgeous. Oh, bless you. For lips, I have this Charlotte Tilbury Pillow Talk kit. Oh, so tiny. Damn. All right, so let me line my lips. I don't know why, but I don't like pink on me, like on my lips. I thought this was gonna be a little bit more creamy. Now going in with the lipstick. Oh, this is cute. Looks like that. This is Pillow Talk. Oh, smells delicious. I'm adding a little bit of gloss, and I'm gonna use the Sephora Gloss in 07 Lover. Favorite. I freaking love it. It's just beautiful. So now we're going to lock everything in place. Oh, she is big. Wow. This is 3.3 fluid ounces. This is what the packaging looks like. Triangle, like always, like all their packaging. This is cute as hell. Look at the lid. Oh, she's cute. I love how this sprays out the product. Wow. All right, so let me read a little bit about this. It says, a super fine, lightweight setting spray that locks makeup in place while reducing the appearance of fine lines, enlarged pores, or skin texture with a soft matte finish. So right now is 11:10 in the morning. I'm going to check in with you guys in a couple hours to see how the makeup is wearing. And I'll see you in a little bit. Hey gorgeous, so it's been like 2 hours since I applied the makeup, and this is what it's looking like. I can definitely see my oils peeking through. Like, my nose is a grease ball. Let's see that concealer. The lips are still on a little bit. I had breakfast. I'll see you in a couple of hours. Hey gorgeous, so this is my last check-in for the day. It's already 4:06, I believe. And this is how the makeup is looking. I'm pretty oily, as usual. Look at my nose. Oh my God, let's look at that under eye. The eyeshadow looks pretty good still, my eyebrows as well. The lips, I can still see a little bit of that lip liner. But the lipstick is totally gone. The blush is intact and the bronzer as well. I mean, I haven't been doing much. I've been just sitting on my sofa editing. So I wanted to give you guys a better close-up of the concealer. So here it is. Look at that. Look at that mascara too. I think she hasn't smudged. She hasn't flaked at all. And it's been already 5 hours. So now I'm going to go back to the studio and give you guys my final thought. So I am here. It is now 4:14. I have had this makeup on for 5 hours, I believe. I think so, yes. And let me zoom you guys in so we can see what it's looking like. Ooh, 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 up close and personal. Oh my God. Okay, so I'm pretty oily. This area right here, like I said, I have a grease ball and is pretty oily. The concealer, I'm sorry, but I don't like the concealer. I feel like I can get something else that's better and probably cheaper. So I'm going to return it, and I'm definitely going to keep everything else. The spray, the setting spray, the foundation, oh my God, my new favorite, that one, and the Sephora best skin ever, period. I don't need nothing else. Maybe for the winter I'm gonna have to get a lighter shade, so yeah, that's about it. But let me see if I can show you guys how oily I am. Everything else looks pretty good, like I told you. The mascara, it's beautiful. Hold on, let me zoom you guys out. I think we can keep it there, yeah. The mascara is beautiful. As for the Charlotte Tilbury lip kit, I liked the durability of the lip liner. The lipstick obviously faded because I ate and I drank water and whatever, but honestly I think it's pretty decent. So that completes today's video. I really hope you guys enjoyed it. Please don't forget to subscribe, hit the like button, and drop a comment down below. Let me know what are your favorites, what should I try next, and I send you muchos besos. Bye.